In this video, we're going to look at the Dropbox and how to submit assignments to your D2L courses. To access the Dropbox, go up to the navigation bar and click on Dropbox. Once here, you'll see a list of the various Dropboxes that you can submit assignments to. They're sorted in the different categories with as many assignments as your instructor wants under each. The basic functions of submitting an assignment are simple. To see this, we'll click on one of the assignments. Under this menu, we can see a few options. First, we have the button to submit our assignment under the Add a File button. Once here, we have four different options as to where to bring our assignment in from. We can submit something from our own computer, from your D2L locker, from a group locker, or from your ePortfolio. For this, we're going to submit something from our own computer. Simply find the file, click it, and hit Open. Once you have your file open, you can either submit another file if you're going to be adding multiple files to this assignment, or you can hit Upload to submit the file you've selected. Now the file is selected but not yet submitted to D2L. Before that, you first have the option as to if you want to submit additional text comments that will be sent to your instructor separate of the actual assignment you've submitted. Here you can provide any additional information you might want or need to. When done, simply hit Submit. Now our assignment has been submitted. You can see that it's been submitted, and you can also receive an email on your UWW email address signifying the assignment, the Dropbox, the time, etc., confirming that your submission was successful. So now we can go back to the main Dropbox page. The next thing you can notice is on the right-hand side of the assignments are a number of icons. For instance, the top one has two icons. One icon is signifying that Turnitin plagiarism detection is enabled. Turnitin automatically takes assignments submitted and scans them for copyrighted material. In a minute, we'll see how that works and how you can view the results. The second icon is an icon signifying that it is a group Dropbox, meaning that only one person from a group has to submit an assignment, and it will count as submitted for everyone in the group. Now, assignments might have one, both, or none of these icons, depending on the parameters your instructor has set. Now let's move over on the right-hand side and look at some of these other categories. The first category is a score. If your instructor has graded and submitted a score for something in the Dropbox, you'll see it right here. Next is your submissions, which shows how many submissions you've submitted under each category. The next is feedback, which will only appear after your instructor has looked at the assignment and submitted feedback. There are a few options under that category which we can see if we click the feedback button. First, we see a list of the different assignments that we've submitted. And below them all, we see a rubric where, if the instructor has provided one, shows us a breakdown of exactly how and why we received the grade that we did. After scrolling all the way through that on the bottom, we can finally see our final score, any additional text feedback, and the submission date. By scrolling up to the top, we can see a bit more detailed information relating to Turnitin. We can see under Report that there is a 1% marker next to the assignment that we submitted. This means that Turnitin has found that 1% of the paper has been, information from the paper has been found on other places in the internet. If we click on the blue marker, we can see a more detailed breakdown of how this number was reached. Now that our paper is loaded, we can see links on the right-hand side to the parts of the paper that were found elsewhere on the internet. The biggest one, making up only 1%, is a simple quotation on the top. By seeing this, we can see that in all likelihood, the paper was probably not plagiarized on a large scale. But if we scroll through, we can also see the other parts that have been marked. In addition to mere plagiarism detection, we also have a few other options on the top. The next one over allows us to see comments submitted by a professor dealing with a specific assignment. Now, there may be text comments on the right-hand side of the screen. In addition to in-paper comments, we can see marked in blue and yellow. By hovering our mouse over each one, we can see a more detailed description of what our professor had to say. Now, when you're done with all this, you can simply exit out of the window, as D2L will open a separate window to view these options. Now we're back on our D2L Dropbox page, where we can do whatever else we have to do. And that covers Dropboxes.